Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Wherever you're watching this from, welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Happy Monday. Hope you're having a wonderful start to the week, coming off an action-packed weekend. Rain in New York City and at Old Trafford. The weather was sunny, but Manchester United fans were raining tears. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. We're talking the Premier League, the upper echelon, the creme de la creme. And the game that went on this weekend left nothing but just a sudden calming lesson when it comes to Manchester United and Chelsea. This edition is going to be all about Manchester United and Chelsea, because at the end of the day, both teams, I don't know who is worse than worse. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The Premier League came back with a bang with games over the weekend, where, of course, Man City doing what Man City does. Let me give you a rundown of the games that went down. Manchester United was the blockbuster game of the weekend, where they lost to Brighton at Old Trafford. Erik ten Hag is playing the referee blame, but if you watch that game, maybe the first 15, 20 minutes, Manchester United had a little bit of spring in their step, but Brighton, all in all, were the better team. It was a lesson on how to play and stay on it. You see, teams who are excelled, they are able to stay on it throughout the whole 90 minutes, and Brighton were so on it. Giuseppe, what he has been able to do, the amount of money they spent compared to Manchester United, and they are splurging. Hoyland, the new striker, got a goal, but it was ruled to be because Marcus Rashford ran the ball out. I mean, the game, Brighton were amazing. 3-1 was the final score. Tariq Lamptey, a player who was I don't know whether he's a left back or a right back, but whichever role he plays, the way he played that game and got the Manchester United defense, it was an amazing game. 3-1 was the final score. Aston Villa are also doing what they do under Unai Emery. A very last minute, they got two goals after the 90th minute whistle. They got two goals in extra time, and it was an amazing game. Crystal Palace felt so bad for them. 3-1 was the final score. Newcastle are about to play in Champions League football. They were able to beat Brentford 1-0, but anyhow, this season, it's been quite a rocky start, and the fluidity and the liquidity of their game is still not there yet compared to last season. They have Champions League football this season, which is an extra level of stress that could be, you know, filled up with a coach. So I want to see how Newcastle will fare in Champions League. They beat Brentford 1-0 with a penalty. Callum Wilson, Chelsea. And the issue about Chelsea now, it hurts to accept that Chelsea is now a mid-level team. When Conor Gallagher and Thiago Silva, the game that we played against Bournemouth, the creation of chances is a broken record. Everybody knows that these crop of players at Chelsea don't know how to put the ball in the net. They are not natural goal scorers. It is fine. You cannot, I don't even blame the players, because anybody with any common sense we'll check the track record and check the style of play. You see, we don't just talk about the game, we're talking about the game from a professorial, empresario perspective. All these players, Nicholas Jackson, I said he was an amazing player. I watched him live when Chelsea came to play. He's a good player, but he's not the answer right now. Nicholas Jackson needed development. He was on the bench at Villarreal. He only got a chance to play when Moreno got injured. He hasn't proven any track record of being a goal scorer for people to be that excited about him. I don't even blame the players. I blame the people behind closed doors who don't have any common sense. And we've said that all Chelsea needs is somebody who can put a ball in the net. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. Chelsea against Bournemouth, a team who is going to guarantee to be fighting relegation. They were just promoted from the Championship, and Chelsea could not beat Bournemouth. Conor Gallagher was the best player on the field, but even him, he got a chance in the penalty box. Shot the ball straight at the goalkeeper. Shoot the ball straight. Chelsea players, they don't even have any idea that they have to twist their waist and shoot the ball with a curve. They just shoot the ball straight. Cole Palmer, once again, another buy. Good player. But what about Cole Palmer? The Chelsea people think that would be the solution to our problems. Cole Palmer got a chance right there. Instead of shooting the ball, he was right in the box. He decided to pass to Raheem Sterling, who is Mr. Run and Run and Run and Run without... Listen to me. Chelsea is now a mid-level team, unfortunately. Or maybe fortunately, because at least Chelsea is not playing Champions League. Because with what they were doing, if they take this to Champions League, like the way they go, but Manchester United is playing in the Champions League against Bayern Munich. I fear. Because the way Manchester United and Chelsea are playing, they are not fit to play in the Champions League. Chelsea, thank God, are not playing Champions League this season. As a Chelsea fan, I'm glad. But Manchester United, they have to back up. Erik ten Hag needs to do something extra, or else the Champions League will be the last time they'll go. Thank you for tuning in to SM Sports. Games are going on today as well. Arsenal also beat Everton 1-0, another game, but it was overshadowed. I mean, Arsenal didn't particularly play well, but hey, that's what champions do. They are able to get wins even when it's not beautiful. Trossard got a wonderful goal, beautiful goal. But all in all, Mikel Arteta still has some work to do. They are also playing Champions League. Today, Nottingham Forest is playing Burnley. Thank you for tuning in to SM Sports. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, new ASEA music, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. Happy Monday. Have a wonderful week. Obadante.